Hello, my name is Laure Elmeguizon, or Dr. H, and I will guide you through this example where we start from the ages of 19 randomly chosen students from Maths 1041. We will produce a five-number summary by hand and using R, and I will remind you how we do this exactly. Then we'll try to find outliers. Again, we'll do it by hand and using R, and we'll produce a box plot by hand and using R. At this point, you may be wondering why we do it by hand, because R can do it for us. The reason is that there is a lot of understanding to be gained from doing it by hand. In particular, I'm pretty sure that a lot of you don't know exactly what goes to the end of the whiskers when we do a box plot. Now, sometimes it's really painful to do things by hand, like for the standard deviation, and in that case, we'll be using R only. The first question asks us to produce a five-number summary of this data. Okay, so what's a five-number summary? The idea of a five-number summary is that you're trying to split your data into four groups of approximately equal size. And the numbers which achieve that form the five-number summary because it's actually a list of five numbers. The first one is the minimum value in your data set. The second one is called Q1, the first quartile, and the name is well chosen because a quarter of the data are smaller than Q1. Q2 is a number you usually know under the name the median, because that's the one that splits your data into basically 50% on one side and 50% on the other side. And the reason the second quartile comes from the fact that there are two quarters of the data below this one. Then there's the third quartile, where three quarters of the data are below it. And finally, the maximum value. So this list of five numbers is what we call a five-number summary. And now let's do it. The first thing we do is to find the median, meaning that we're trying to split this group of 19 numbers into two groups of equal size. Well, 19 is odd, so that's impossible. But the closest thing we can do is to put 9 numbers on one side, 9 numbers on the other side, and then there will be a middle number, which will be the median. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 numbers there. 9 numbers there. And that's my median, which is also the second quartile. Please note that we do not get the five numbers of the five-number summary from smallest to largest. You need to start by the median. So then what you want to do is to split again the groups you have there in half. And the doubt you may have is that the group I need to split in half, or should I include the median? Well, the answer is there. If there is an odd number of observation, the middle one, the median, is used twice, once to compute Q1 and once to compute Q3. That means if I want to get the first quartile, this is what I'm looking at. Now I have 10 values. So if I want to split my 10 value into two equal groups, what I'm going to do is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is where my value is, and in that case, the quartile is going to be the average of these two numbers. Well, the average of 19 and 19 is fairly easy to calculate. Same thing for the upper half of the numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is where the break should be, 5 number on either side. And again, I'm going to average the two value to get my third quartile, which will have to be 22.5. We are now ready to write down our five-number summary. So the first number is the minimum value, that's 18. Then the first quartile is 19. Of course, I'm getting it from here. The median is going to be 20. My third quartile is 22.5. And the maximum value in this data set is 29. The second part of this question is to produce the same five-number summary, but this time using R. So the first thing you need to do is to combine all your numbers, the C's for combine, into just one object, which you called H. And then you use an instruction called 5num for five-number summary for H. and you get exactly what we had earlier. That's the minimum value. Then you get the first quartile, then you get the median, then the third quartile, and finally, the maximum value. We have to warn you, you will have a few surprises when you compute the quartiles because there are at least 9 different rules to compute them. In practice, it will probably be unimportant because this time we're doing a 5-number summary using a very small data set, but it's not unusual instead that you will do that with thousands and thousands of value. And in that case, the quantiles you get are so close, it makes no difference. And anyway, in the context of a course, usually since there are several accepted definitions, write whatever you got with your software and it's going to be counted correct.